Hi everyone, my name is Mehar Sindhu Batra and I'm back with another video. Today's video is another interview series where I will be interviewing my sister Shreya, who's currently a product manager at an American startup called Abbas. She did her computer science engineering from JP Institute, Noida. After that, she went on to work at Infosys, India Mart, and Times Internet. Please welcome Shreya Batra Gupta.
Hi, Meher.
Hi, Shreya. Welcome to our video.
Thank you so much. So excited to be here at MSP Vision.
We are so excited to have you because Shreya is actually the first interview that I'm conducting specifically for engineering students. So this is a new beginning for all of us together.
That's great. I'm very excited and I hope I could help you guys as well.
That's great. I'm sure you will. So since you're our first engineering interviewee, we have a ton of questions that came in from all our students on the channel and I'm so excited to kickstart this interview. So why don't we start with a little bit about your background, your journey, your childhood. So let's start with that.
So I have done my schooling from Delhi. I'm basically from Delhi and I started in APJ school. And my schooling, I was always an A student and I was a big nerd. Very bad at sports, very bad at all extracurricular. But yes, art was something that always I had a soft corner for and I always used to find my way to go there. But studies was something that I was, that was a big part of me throughout my life. That's what actually pushed me to take science in my 11th and 12th. That was also a reason that my parents always, you know, guided me. People like us didn't have MSB Vision, so we didn't really know what to do in our lives.
So
at that time, we felt whatever parents feel for us, that's the best thing. Plus my elder brother Shashank was also an engineer and he also took science. So it just felt right at that particular point of time and I just went for it. I scored pretty well in my 10th and 12th. I mean, scoring 93% in 12th in science was a big deal at that particular point of time.
It's just amazing.
Yeah, so you can imagine what kind of a nerd I was.
Good.
Yeah, so
great. So then how did you decide to do engineering? You know, like you said, you were a big nerd, but even as a science student, you have so many options, even in a non-medical stream. So why engineering and why computer science engineering?
To be very honest, I don't know why. Honestly, my elder brother is an engineer. We have another engineer in the family and everybody was doing well. It just felt like, you know, that's the option. And engineers were something that everybody was looking up to. So it just felt that that's a very good option to go for. And personally, at that time, I didn't know what I wanted in my life. So I don't know if you want to hear that, but I don't know why I did engineering.
But did you ever feel like there was a lot of pressure on you to do engineering, or did you think that, okay, no, I like science, I enjoy it and I like computers, so this may be a good career option for me?
Honestly, there was a lot of pressure on me because I wanted to explore Delhi University a bit. I scored so well in my 12th standard that I was getting SRCC at that time.
Wow.
So, you know, skipping SRCC and going to another engineering college which wasn't that renowned was a tough choice to make at that time, but it was mostly pressure that, you know, engineers are somebody you can look up to, so yeah, why not just go for it?
Yeah, they're like professionals.
They're like professionals, they work in big corporations, and that is something that pushed me for it. But yeah, that was why I did it.
Great. So why don't you tell us about your college life? Where did you do your engineering from and how was the whole experience?
I did my engineering from JP Institute of Information Technology. I got in through AIEEE. That used to happen back then. But now it's a different thing and you need to take JEE Phase 1 and Phase 2, through which you get into IITs as well as all other colleges as well. So my college gave us a lot of options to explore different subjects which were non-science, and you know, I could choose from marketing, economics and personal development as well. So that really helps you, you know, when you're an engineer and when you go to corporate jobs, it's not just about coding. You also need to have some personality to work in those big corporates. So that is something that, you know, really helped us there. So JP was really good when it comes to that.
Let's talk about, you know, the placements then. How did you land a job at Infosys at such a young age of like 21, 22?
So, you know, the placements begin in your third year, and that's the scariest time for any engineer, because lots of companies are going to come, but you get just one company that you get selected to, and you cannot look at any other company. That's a rule that most of the engineering colleges follow during this time. And I had to choose if I want to work for a startup or I wanted to work for a big corporation which had a big name. Both of them had their own pros and cons, but that time I wanted to go work for a big firm because I thought that it would help me grow in a way and have good brand names attached to my resume. So I sat for Infosys. It was a 9-hour long interview process. I had to give aptitude tests, coding tests, and finally have interviews with Infosys people. And it was a long process, but yes, I finally got through that. I also had one less semester. Like my college was 7 semesters rather than 8 semesters that everybody else has. My last semester was actually my training period in Infosys, which was also a plus for me because that gave me an extra time to start my career.
Oh, so you actually had the practical experience in your last semester, and that helped you get a permanent job, right?
That's true. So my last semester was just a month, and then we had to go to Infosys, get our training there, and then submit our project there as well, and then finally get placed at Infosys. So it wasn't just getting your interview and getting the job.
So you have to prove yourself in that training period.
That's true. Oh, so if you flunk, you lose the job.
Wow, that's very competitive.
That's very competitive, and Infosys, trust me guys, Infosys has the worst training ever and the best training ever at the same time. So why I say that is because they teach you so well, you would learn everything in those 4 months that you wouldn't even have learned in your college. So plus the Mysore campus is the best thing that will happen to you in your life. I mean, that's my favorite part ever in my complete career of 6.5 years.
Wow.
So, yeah. So, plus, I would say worst because it's so tough that you're studying each and every day of your life in those 4 months.
Oh, God. So, you actually moved from Noida to Mysore for that training period?
True. I moved from Noida to Mysore for that training period for 4 months.
Okay, and then where did you start working at Infosys?
Yeah, I moved to Pune campus from Mysore. That was where I was placed.
Wonderful, great. So how was it working at Infosys once you were done with the training period and once you were a permanent employee?
So at Infosys, I was working as a hybrid app developer. I was building apps for iOS as well as Android, but the code was one. That's why it is called as hybrid. The main thing that helped me doing that, taking up that project at Infosys, was my web designing course back in college, which was actually my favorite subject as well. So I was working as a UI developer building those apps.
Oh, wonderful. And how was the culture at Infosys? You know, it's such a big organization recognized around the world. But what were some of the challenges that you faced?
One biggest challenge that you would face at a mass corporation would be you're lost. I mean, that's a big word to say, but you know, between thousands of employees and within one project there are 500 people working, you don't have an opinion as a fresher. Even if you feel that something is wrong, nobody is going to listen to you unless your manager himself comes to you and says that, okay, this probably is wrong. So you are basically lost in your organization, and it's very difficult to prove yourself when you're a fresher there.
Because the competition is so high.
It's not about competition, it's all about your level. There are such a big hierarchy that you're very much at the bottom of that hierarchy. And to give your opinion and to be listened to, you need to prove and go up the ladder a bit.
So it's very bureaucratic.
You could say that.
Got it. So too many layers above you.
Too many layers. I mean, in my own project, I had a team of say 11 people, and all 10 others were above me.
So that's what, my friends, you have to start at the most junior level in your first job. You can't be expected to, you know, manage a team of 15 people unless you're doing your own venture, unless you started your own thing.
That's very true.
So you have to prove yourself and then move up the ranks. So it's not easy for anyone starting their careers, whether you're an accountant, whether you're an engineer, it's all the same no matter what you do. So please,
that's very true.
Please don't feel disheartened. You know, I get a lot of messages from students saying that, you know, we're doing these super jobs and we're hating our work. But that's where you start. That's where you build your reputation in the organization and then you move up.
Guys, I started my first job at Infosys at a stipend of 4,000 rupees per month. If that gives you any encouragement, please take that.
Great. So let's talk about what happened after Infosys. What was the next step for you? Why did you want to switch your job after 1.5 years?
Like I said, I mean, the pay was so bad and the workload was so much that you feel like moving away from that. Plus, I also wanted to move to Delhi. And that was one big reason that I wanted to come back to my home and start my life there again.
So see, personal reasons also impact your career decisions. So when you are making decisions, you have to, you know, weigh both personal aspects of your life as well as professional aspects. And many times those career decisions will be dependent on personal aspects. And that's what made you move, right?
Yeah, that's true. I mean, I'm happy that I moved because where I am right now, that was the first decision of my life that made me come here, you know. So moving to Delhi was one of the best decisions I took in my life.
So how did you move to Delhi and then start applying for a job, or did you start applying from Pune?
No, so I took a sabbatical for 1.5 months and I moved back home and I took, I applied everywhere I could. And I found this job at IndiaMART. I found some other jobs also at mass corporations like Infosys, but I did not want to go there because having that experience and feeling lost there, I wanted to move to a little smaller organization, but having an opinion there. So I moved to IndiaMART, which is in Greater Noida. And I was working again as a software developer there as well.
So then, how long were you working at IndiaMART?
I was again working for 1.5 years, yeah.
Were you enjoying that job profile? Did you think it was challenging enough? Was your opinion being heard?
When I moved from Infosys to IndiaMART, I thought my profile is going to be the same as Infosys, which would be a software developer. But there were so many options here at IndiaMART where I could explore, and the culture was so great that my managers helped me at every step. I started learning data analytics because that's what my managers there, who were actually called product managers, they used to study on day-to-day basis. So they used to study data, they used to drive insights from that, and then they used to tell the developers what to do and what not to do. Data analytics was so much fun that I could relate what I'm doing as a developer, what feature I'm developing, and what is actually it's causing to the business, what's the impact of it. So I learned that there, and slowly in IndiaMART itself, I got an opportunity to lead a team of 3 developers and play a role of product manager under my product manager, of course.
So you're leading a team of 3 at the age of 24?
Yeah, I mean, that was the best thing happened to me, honestly.
That's so amazing, and I think that's such a contrast from what you were doing before. So I think the cultural difference must have really excited you, no?
The culture difference was so good. All the employees were almost our age or probably 3 years older to me. So everybody wanted to just learn. Everybody wanted to just share their knowledge. And that's what helped me grow as a person, because I learned it from them that, you know, you just don't grow by keeping your knowledge to yourself. You need to share it with the world. And that's how you grow as a community.
That's so amazing, Shreya. And I think that makes us realize that you can do big things at a young age also. Definitely. And the right opportunity is sometimes in the right organization. So if you're in a job that you feel that you don't fit in at, please explore. There are other options available, and there could be an organization that could be the best for you. Right?
True. I mean, you need to just keep exploring. The exploration never stops.
And there's no point being in a job that you hate. I mean, there are so many options out there. There are so many people who are hating their jobs in a toxic environment. They're working with people who don't understand them, who don't give them that, you know, freedom to do things the way they want to, or they treat them badly. I don't think there's a point in sticking to those kind of jobs, right?
definitely. I mean, you have so many options. I know it takes courage to leave your first job or second job and move to another one. So at IndiaMART, I used to wake up at 6 a.m. in the morning, travel 2.5 hours, spend 9 hours there, travel 2.5 hours again, and come back home. So the only thing that was driving me was the work. The work was so amazing that I just felt the need to wake up in the morning and just go for it.
So what made you leave IndiaMART if it was so amazing, and when did you actually leave? After how long?
So I left IndiaMART after 1 year and 8 months of my journey. I never wanted to leave that, but again, it was some personal reasons. Like I said, I had to travel like 4.5 hours a day and it was deteriorating my health. And I had to move away and move to an organization probably a little closer to my place. I did not want to move to Noida just for the job, because the only reason I moved to Delhi from Infosys was to be at home.
And then what did you do? What was the next move of your career?
So at IndiaMART, I made such good connections that my manager took me with her to Times Internet. She moved to Times Internet and she wanted to take me along with her, because that's how it works. Your networking works like that, and importance of networking is so high that she easily made me transit from one job to another, and I had a similar role there, and that was definitely pretty close to my home, so everything worked in my favor there.
That's so amazing. So see, you could be developing strong relationships in any job that you're doing, and those relationships will always help you in the long run. So please, my friends, do develop these strong connections, these work on maintaining these relationships, because you never know when and how they would come in handy later.
Very true. And I still feel she was my best manager because she taught me so much.
So amazing. I hope you're still in touch with her.
I am, definitely.
So then what did you do at Times Internet?
So I was a technical analyst at Times Internet, and my role was basically studying data and driving insights around that. And yes, sharing those insights with product managers again, and developing features around that.
So again, you moved to a big organization after working at a smaller one. Was that challenging again to adjust in that environment?
Whereas Times Internet was very challenging because it was more competitive. And for me as a person, my weakness is being too polite. Whereas Times Internet was about people who were very vocal and strongly opinionated. So I had some challenge, setting up there.
Great. So how long did you work there, and then what was your next career move?
Yeah, so I worked there for 2 years, and then I decided to pivot because my main aim was to become a product manager. And I thought that it was right time for me to move to a different organization and look for that sort of a role.
Great. So by now you have worked at 3 organizations and you are looking to move into your 4th one. So what was this 4th one that you're currently working at? What is that all about?
So here in my final organization, I am working as a product manager. This is an American startup where I'm taking care of their 4 products. And I am completely responsible for every feature that goes into that product. And all those features actually impact the revenue completely. So that's a big role that I was offered, and I'm so grateful to have that and to be working as that.
A lot of students asked that how did you manage to get that job? So why don't you tell us about the recruitment process?
It wasn't easy. I left my Times Internet job in the middle. I did not had any job in hand. I took a break of 1 month. I researched and studied how can I become a product manager, because my previous profile doesn't say so. Plus, I did not have an MBA degree. So, moving from a technical analyst to a product manager, it wasn't easy. So I interviewed with a lot of organizations. I also networked with a lot of people on LinkedIn. LinkedIn came as very handy to me, and I learned more and more what these people do. I did handle a team of 3 at IndiaMART, but that wasn't enough, right? So I needed to learn more. I attended a lot of conferences. I read a lot of articles as well to understand the main role and to understand how to get there. And I interviewed with so many organizations and I finally cracked this one.
That's so amazing. So see, she really hustled hard to get the position she wanted. And it's not going to be very easy to pivot into a new role. You have to know what it's all about. You have to go and network with people. You have to do all your groundwork, your homework, all the research beforehand. You can't just go for an interview and expect to get hired, you know. So the work has to be done by you, not anyone else.
Yes, so that 1 month when I was just researching about it, I wasn't sad that I, you know, skipped 1 month salary or something.
So do you think you're in your dream job right now?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I would want to move up the ladder for sure, but where I am right now, this has been my dream for 4 years in the making, yes.
So Shreya, you landed your dream job at the age of 28, having worked at 3 different organizations in different technical roles, you know, pivoting big, small, medium-sized organization to land up at a startup. So you have this huge amount of experience and knowledge at working at large corporations, and now you're managing a diverse team of different types of individuals and doing different types of roles. How does it feel to, you know, be sitting at this position of a product manager at a startup that is growing so quickly in the US?
It feels fantastic. I mean, I have worked really hard to get where I am. I am so content right now that it feels great to be here.
So you worked hard and you achieved what you wanted to.
I mean, there's still a long way to go, but yes.
That's amazing. You also want to keep learning and keep growing as a professional.
Definitely. I mean, I would say this is just the beginning and I have a long way to go and probably become the CEO of a company.
That's so cool and so ambitious. So let's compare working at a startup versus working at a large corporation.
Okay, so as I already told you, my experience at Infosys was that I was lost. I did not have an opinion. But when I see my juniors working in a startup, the American startup that I'm working at, everybody has an opinion and everybody is listened to. How these startups work is amazing because there is so much freedom that these provide you. You can learn anything, you can do anything, but the only one thing that these organizations require is that you work hard for them. I mean, you, whatever you are doing is should be to make that organization grow.
So that's so amazing. I think what you're trying to say is there's a flat hierarchy. Everyone's voice, everyone's opinion matters. Everyone has a voice. And of course, you have to, because you have that freedom, that independence, they expect you to treat it like your own baby, like your own organization.
Yes, I mean, my CEO, whenever I'm speaking to my CEO, he tells me that this is your own organization. This is, you have to grow with it and you have to grow the organization. So that is one thing. He gives me all the freedom that I want, but in return, all he wants is to be honest to the organization and to be loyal to the organization and treat it as it's your own.
Yeah, and of course, hustle to make it grow. Right?
Yeah, obviously.
Great. So let's talk about, you know, you being a female in an industry that is mostly male oriented. Sorry to say, but that is the truth. There are hardly any women in tech. So what do you think were your challenges as a woman?
As you said that it's male dominated, honestly all my colleagues felt that a woman can't code. You know, this is one thing that most men think, which also came to me. But trust me, it's just about syntax and using a little logic together. So it's not rocket science. Anybody can do it. It doesn't have to be a male or a female to be learning about that. And that was one challenge that I faced.
So do you feel like you're the only girl in a room full of men or in a sea of men?
So Meher, honestly, in my current job, I am the only female and my team has about 20 to 22 male members.
Oh my god.
So it's tough, but I am lucky to have colleagues like what I have right now. Because they're very supportive and I have a voice and they value it more than anybody else. So, but talking about only female in the room, I am currently into one of those roles.
does that stop you from speaking the truth or speaking what you really feel?
No, never. I mean, as I said, startups give you a lot of freedom and they want you to experiment as much as you can. And that is what I'm doing. I mean, this startup has given me more confidence in my life than anything else. It's been a brilliant thing that happened to me.
So what is your role as a product manager? What does a product manager do?
Okay, that's interesting. So I would say on day one, I'm a sales manager selling my product to my customers. On day two, I'm a designer because I'm sitting with my design team to get the best aesthetics for my product. Day three, I'm a developer helping my development team to create logic or develop things around that. Day four, I'm a CEO working to grow my organization. Day five, I'm a marketing lead marketing my product to reach to every user possible in America. So I am actually at the center of all these roles, and I'm communicating and coordinating with each and every team that exists in my company.
Wow, so you wear so many hats.
Yes, I mean, that's my role, and if you Google it, the first thing about product manager says that we work as a mini CEO.
So cool, you're a CEO at such a young age.
I would love to call myself that.
Great, amazing, Shreya. So we are approaching towards the end of the interview now, and I would just want you to end this by thinking back to, you know, 10, 12 years, and what is the advice that you would give to your younger self, or what is the advice that you would give to someone who's 15, 16 watching this right now?
So when you're 15, 16, I don't think a lot of us know what we want in life, and it's difficult because our parents, mostly it's our parents telling us that you should be doing this or that, or this is good or this is not good. But all I would want to say is, keep a track of something that excites you. Keep a track of your passions, because when I was in college, I didn't know that I wanted to be a product manager, but web designing, marketing, and data, that really excited me. I didn't know how to bring all of that together, but now I know, working as a product manager, I can bring all those things on the table and they all work in my favor. So definitely you wouldn't know what role you want to be when you're 30, but you would know your passions. So just keep a track of that and try to understand what are the options that you can explore from those passions, because that is how you're going to love your job by the time you're 30 or 40. So that is one thing that I would want to tell myself when I was, say, 15 years old. And if I get a chance, I would want to go back and do everything all over again, because now I know what I like.
Wow, that's such amazing advice, Shreya. And do you think you would do anything differently?
No, I think every experience counts, and at every stage in my life, I learned so much that I would not want to change anything, and I have no regrets at all.
So amazing, and so amazing to be at this position and have no regrets.
That's true. That's very true.
Great. So do you want to end this with some final thoughts?
So I would want to tell you guys that you can't give up at any stage of your life. There would be lots of challenges that you face, maybe professional, maybe personal. And if you are a female, you would be dominated with this male-centric society. But you just need to keep going, and you need to have a goal in mind that you would want to achieve. Because without having a goal in mind, you're not working for anything, and that would not take you anywhere. So have that goal and just try to achieve it with every step that you take in your future.
That's amazing. Thank you so much, Shreya, for joining us. It's been a pleasure.
Thanks, Meher. I love being here, and I'm so excited to watch this video on your YouTube channel.
Yay, great. And I want to say that Shreya has been one of my true supporters, and support that a family gives to other family members. So thank you for being such a support for my channel and my Instagram page, and all the love that you shower on us. Thank you.
Always. I am waiting for a celebrity at my home.
Great. Awesome. Thank you. So that's it, my friends. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel and share and like this video with all your friends who are planning to do engineering, because I know they will find it useful. It's full of gems, and You know, it's all about learning from other people's experience. I'll be back soon with another one. But until then, keep working hard, keep hustling, and keep that end goal in mind, as Shreya said. I hope to see you soon. Bye. These are bloopers.
So at Infosys, I was working as an Android. So I was a technical analyst. I was a technical analyst at.
Where were you?
Whereas Times Internet was very competitive, and people just wanted to move up the ladder, and it was challenging for me to be there because I was. Be there.